Okay, welcome back. Let's take a look at this demo. As I said, it's a simple user interface built with Gradio. And here we have this field for the question, for the message. And then in the upper field, we will have answers from our language model. In our case, we use a pretty simple language model. It's not a huge online model like GPT-4 or Claude. So that's why it probably doesn't have answers to all the questions. Like, for example, recently we had a benchmark test with Intel products, and I want to ask a question about those benchmarks. Tell me about Intel Sapphire Rapids benchmark with MinIO. Let's see. You see, the model says it doesn't know. Because, of course, this is a document which was not included in its training dataset. Let's upload a document which covers those benchmarks and then ask that same question again. You see, we have a bucket called Custom Corpus, which we can use to upload our documents. It's currently empty, nothing in there. So we upload a file, and we have a bunch of PDF files which I downloaded from the MinIO web server. We find this Sapphire Rapids small objects benchmark and upload it here. Okay, so far so good. Remember, when I just uploaded this PDF file, something is happening. This file is split into several pieces, then each piece is vectorized and stored in the vector database on the same MinIO object storage server. And now this vector database can provide some context which will help this application to answer the question which we ask. Let's just repeat the same question and see what happens. You see, it's answering and it's giving us pretty concrete results of those benchmarks. Which servers were used, what kind of throughput which was achieved, and so on and so forth. It's pretty cool, right? So we added just a single document, and now we are able to answer very, very specific questions. And also, I told you that in our UI, we have a section which gives us the context. And here we have five pieces of our documents, which were used to provide the context and which were sent to the language model to get the answer back. So this is how it works. And this is how we use documents to answer specific questions. Then in your case, you might need maybe 10, 20, 50 documents to upload to the database, to upload to the bucket, and then vectorize them and store them in the vector database. And then if those documents are very specific to your area, then you will be able to ask questions about this area. So this is a short demo of our application. And now you are ready to reproduce the same application using our lab instructions. Take a look at the document in our lab instructions archive, and then follow them, and you will be ready to build the same application yourself. Thank you, and see you in the lab.